Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For those of you who are first learning Photoshop, I'm going to show you how to quickly create the look of vintage 8mm movie still frames from modern color photographs. The technique that I'm going to show you can be applied to virtually any photograph. Later in this tutorial, we'll be applying this texture of movie film scratches to our image. The link to this texture is located in the video description or project files. First, click off the lock icon to unlock the background. Now the layer can be moved anywhere on the layers panel. To find your photo and place it into this file, go to File and place Embedded. A window automatically opens which contains all the folders in your computer. Go to the location where your photo is and click on the photo. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock.com. Click Place. It automatically places the photo onto our film scratches document and resizes the photo to fit the height of the document it's being placed onto. To accept it, click the check mark or press Enter or Return. Place Embedded also did one more thing. It automatically made the photo into a smart object. This allows us to make non-destructive adjustments to it. Click the thumbnail of the texture to make it active and drag it above your photo. To fit the sides of the texture to the sides of the photo, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl-T on Windows or Command-T on a Mac. Go to the middle of a side, and when you see a horizontal double arrow, press and hold Shift and Alt or Shift and Option as you drag it in until it's slightly overlapping the photo. Then press Enter or Return. Click off the eyeball of the texture to temporarily hide it, and click the thumbnail of your photo to make the photo active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 to 3 pixels. For this image, I'll blur it 2 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Reduce the saturation between -50 to -80. Adjust the saturation based on your photo's color intensity. Make the texture visible and active and change its blend mode to multiply. To crop off the empty areas on the sides, Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the texture to make a selection of its outer boundaries. Go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command-D. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.